Hello and welcome to Mumbai Matters. I'm Purva Chitnis, special correspondent with The Print. Today in this episode of Mumbai Matters, we will be discussing about Metro 3, that is Mumbai's first underground metro. Now, ahead of Maharashtra Assembly election, Mumbai's first underground metro corridor, which is considered to be the costliest infrastructure projects in the city, is expected to partially start operations by the end of this month. The first phase of this 33.3-kilometer corridor was expected to earlier open partially in July. However, the deadline was later pushed to August, and now the officials of Mumbai Metro Rail Corporation, that is MMRC, which is the joint venture of the union and state governments that is implementing this project, they hope that it will be able to have the flag-off ceremony before the model code of conduct comes into force. Now remember, in just few months, Maharashtra will go into assembly elections. Coming back to Metro, the part of the corridor that will be open for operation starts from the RA Colony Car Depot to the business district of Bandra Kurla Complex. The entire corridor will stretch till Cuff Parade in South Mumbai. The first phase, which once open, will provide relief to Mumbaikers who are commuting in the western suburbs. It will also connect an already functional metro line, that is the west to east Versova-Andheri-Ghatkopar corridor, and this connection will be at Marol Naka, from where people can access eastern suburbs with some ease. MMRC officials also hope that this will boost connectivity between business districts such as Andheri MIDC, BKC, SIBS, along with the travel to Mumbai's Chhatrapati Shivaji International Airport. The second phase of this line, which is also known as Metro 3 in Mumbai, it will be from BKC to Cuff Parade, and this is expected to be commissioned by March 2025, that is 6 months from now. So let's understand what is the current status of Metro 3 project. Now, as per MMRC, for the entire line, as of August 31, overall 93% project work is completed, 99.4% civil work is completed, and for phase 1, 98.4% work is complete, while for phase 2, 86.7% overall work is complete till August 31st. MMRC is confident that it is able to open partially this first phase of Metro 3 because they have obtained the RDSO, that is the Research Designs and Standards Organization clearance, as well as the ISA certificate, which is required for the safety purpose. Now, for phase 1 from RA to BKC, MMRC has also submitted an application to invite the Commissioner of Railway Metro Safety to inspect and give his final stamp of approval on the functioning of this train. Plus, one more application will be sent to invite this Railway Commissioner for inspection of few other systems while the testing of electrical and other systems and its work is in final stages. Now, once all these inspections are done, the corridor will be commissioned. This means that the corridor will officially be open. The CMRC approval process includes inspections, trial runs, evaluation of train design, braking system, fire safety, signaling system, among others. The first phase of Metro 3 has 10 stations, out of which 9 will be underground, and they will be spread over 12 km, while the entire corridor, as I mentioned earlier, is 33.5 km long and has in total 27 stations. The 9 underground stations that will start functioning as a part of the first phase are SIBS, MIDC, Marol Naka, CSMIA T2, that is the international airport, CSMIA T1, that is the domestic airport, Sahar Road Station, Santa Cruz, Vidyanagari and BKC station, and the RAJVLR station will be not underground, but it will be a grade station. The entire line will have stations at Cuff Parade, Vidhan Bhavan, Church Gate. Now remember, all these stations come in South Mumbai and they are quite important iconic destinations as well in Mumbai. Hutatma Chowk, CST Metro, Kalba Devi, Girgaon, Grant Road, Mumbai Central Metro, Mahalakshmi, Science Museum, Acharya Atre Chowk, Varli, Siddhivinayak, Dadar, Sitla Devi, Dharavi, BKC, and the rest, as I mentioned earlier. Now, this train has been 10 years in the making. Why so? What are those challenges? The groundbreaking ceremony, in fact, for this line was held in August 2014 at Marol, but the construction work started only in 2016. This was a particular metro line which was embroiled in a lot of controversy over the location of the car shed, the construction in some very congested areas, and the COVID-19 pandemic also slowed down the progress on this corridor. The cost of this project then escalated from an original 23,136 crore to, as of now, it is 37,276 crore, which is estimated now. The project is being implemented with financial assistance from JICA, that is Japan International Cooperation Agency. Now, other than being the focal point of a political tussle between BJP and Shiv Sena Uddhav Balasaheb Thackeray, the RA Metro Car Depot also faced stiff resistance from environmentalists and activists who staged multiple protests at site, with a large number of people from the civil society also joining them and resisting a car depot inside the RA forest. The matter went into the Supreme Court, and finally overcoming major hurdles and a delay of 2 years, in 2022, the Supreme Court finally gave its nod for construction inside RA. Now, apart from political and legal hurdles, there were also challenges including the civil work and construction, especially in the congested areas of Kalba Devi, Girgaon, which will be a part of phase 2 as I mentioned earlier. These stations would be constructed near buildings, and some areas are important from a heritage point of view. For the first time in India, 17 tunnel boring machines were deployed simultaneously for the underground tunnels. But despite these challenges, Mumbai Underground Metro is partially ready to open now. The flagging off will be done ahead of the elections and mostly at the hands of Prime Minister Narendra Modi. But keeping all of that aside, Mumbaikers will finally get to ride on the city's first underground metro, hopefully by the end of this month. We will be tracking this story, and for more updates, we will keep on tracking this story. That's all we have for you in this episode of Mumbai Matters. This is me, Purva Chitnis, signing off.